हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू योर ओन चैनल डेली कमोडिटी। टुडेज टॉपिक इज व्हाट इज जिंक एज अ कमोडिटी, व्हाई इज जिंक वैल्यूएबल, फाइव मेजर कंट्री विच प्रोड्यूसेस जिंक, फाइव मेजर यूजेस ऑफ दी जिंक एंड व्हाट आर दी फैक्टर्स विच ड्राइव्स दी जिंक प्राइसेस। लेट मी रिमाइंड यू, इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल येट, प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दी बेल आइकन टू गेट ऑल दी अपडेट्स फ्रॉम डेली कमोडिटी। सो लेट्स बिगिन। There are different metals available which has many different uses. What is zinc as a commodity? Zinc is the fourth most widely used metal in the world after steel, aluminium and copper. There is many property of a zinc which make it different from other metals, like it is hard and brittle at most temperature but malleable between 100 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. Zinc is good conductor of heat and electricity and burns with a bright bluish green flame giving off zinc oxide. What are the uses of the zinc oxide? We'll let you know in the next part of the video. So keep watching video till the end. Zinc is used to produce brass, which is a zinc alloy that contains between 55 and 95% of copper. Zinc occurs naturally in the earth's crust and it is the 24th most abundant element, which is about 1.9 billion tons of identified resources. Zinc is a bluish white element that can be refined into a metal. It resists corrosion and therefore it is often used to galvanize iron and steel. Due to its resistance to non-acidic atmosphere, corrosion zinc plays a vital role in extending the life of the vehicle, ships and so on. The metal is mainly used as an anti-corrosion agent and a coat of a zinc prevents rusting of galvanizing steel. Why is zinc so valuable? Zinc is valuable because it's different types of property and uses. It is the fourth metal which is produced in the world. How is zinc produced? Two sources, which is primary production, that is mining of the metal, and secondary production, which is basically a recycling of the metal. More than 80% of the zinc mining takes place in the underground mines. Zinc and lead ores usually occurs together and they often contain other valuable metals such as silver, gold and copper, etc. The process of the primary production involves four basic steps, which includes ore concentration, smelting, refining and alloying. Secondary production is a process of recycling, which is economically viable activity. In the United States, about 35 tons of zinc is being recycled annually. Recycling material includes the residue from the process of galvanizing zinc with steel and zinc oxide recovered from blast furnace. Today, mine worldwide extracts more than 11.9 million metric tons of zinc annually. Zinc mine exists in more than 50 countries around the world. The metal plays a key role in the steel, which means it is important part of a steel industry. With this point, you can conclude that how important and valuable the metal zinc is. But do you know which is the leading country of mining zinc in the world from this 50 countries? The answer is China. Yes, you heard right. China is a leading zinc mining country in the world. It produces almost 40% of the annual supply of the metal, and that is also one of the reasons that demand and supply in China determines the zinc prices, which you would see in the further part of the videos. Which country has the most zinc mining? Here are the top 5 countries for mining zinc. First comes China, 4,500 metric tons. Second, Peru, 1,300 metric tons. Third, Australia, 850 metric tons. United States, 780 metric tons. Mexico, 710 metric tons. What are the 5 main uses of zinc? Zinc is used as a galvanizing material, galvanizing of the steel and iron. prevents corrosion and rusting. Electroplating is the most common method. You have heard about galvanizing steel. Items including car bodies, street lamp posts, safety barriers and suspension bridge use galvanized steel. Zinc is also used as an alloy. Zinc combines with the other metal to form the strong alloy. Brass, nickel, silver and aluminium solder are example of zinc alloy. Musical instruments and hardware items uses brass in the construction, while the electric items and the pipes uses solder. Die casting is a process of production of the metal parts using the molds. The automobile companies, electrical and hardware industries all uses zinc for the die casting parts. Zinc oxide is also used by many companies for the paint, rubber, cosmetics, pharmaceutical, plastic, ink, soap and battery, textile, electric equipment. Manufacturer of many products use zinc oxide in the production. The last is zinc sulfide. Zinc sulfide is an important component in many products, luminous paints, fluorescent light, x-rays, screens, etc. Zinc is also an essential nutrient for living thing. A typical human body contains about 2.5 grams of zinc and consumes 15 milligrams per day. Food with high zinc content includes herring, beef, lamb, cheese and sunflower seeds. What drives the prices of the zinc? The price of the zinc is driven mostly by this 5 factors: Chinese demand, Chinese supply, global stock, US demand, input prices. Now let us see what is Chinese demand and how does it affects the zinc prices. As most industries, industrial commodities, China play a pivotal role in determining zinc price. China is a top consumer of refined zinc used in a galvanized steel. Therefore, a key indicator of zinc demand in China and everywhere else is steel demand. Decision about whether to undertake or hold off on infrastructural projects can create a huge fluctuation in steel demand. Ultimately, this decision can flow through the zinc market. Stimulating measures can stroke demand for this commodities, while tighter monetary can depress them. Second point, Chinese supply. A key factor impacting zinc output in the China is the country's increasing environmentally awareness. Poor air quality has forced the government to take harder look at the mining industry as a contributor to pollution. In China, curbs the production of the zinc to deal with the problems, then the country will more reliant on the imports. This could drive price higher. Third point is global stock. The London Metal Exchange keeps track of a global stock level for zinc and other industrial metals. Traders follow this inventory levels closely for the clue about supply shortage or surplus. If the inventory level drops, the market may be facing the shortage of the zinc supply in the near future. This could lead to higher prices for metal. Similarly, if stock piling occurs and inventory level expands, then the market might face an oversupply of a metal, which can lead to lower prices. Fourth point is US demand. Construction and infrastructure represent a very large percentage of galvanized steel demand. The United States have not invested in major infrastructural projects in the decades. If the government earmarked funding for new infrastructural projects, the price of the steel could move significantly higher. This could likely create increased demand for zinc and results in higher prices. A strong US economy also increases demand for the automobile. Ultimately, the transportation sector is very reliable barometer for galvanized steel and zinc demand. The last point is input prices. Zinc occurs in ore bodies, and breaking down these ore bodies to extract elements expands energy. Mining and refining zinc requires ample supply of coal, electricity and crude oil. The cost can have a big effect on primary production. Similarly, the cost of scrap metal can impact the price of the secondary production. So if you like the video, please like, share, subscribe. Thank you.